Distinguished members of the subcommittee, thank you for inviting me here to discuss the administration's policy toward Iran and the progress we have made since January 2009. The key objectives of this administration's Iran policy remain to prevent it from acquiring nuclear weapons, our foremost priority, from supporting terrorism, from committing human rights abuses, and from destabilizing the region. We have enacted the toughest sanctions Iran has faced. Our policy is making Iran's current course unsustainable, reducing its options, and deepening its isolation. Indeed, Iran is an outcast among nations. The U.S. Comprehensive Iran Sanctions Accountability and Divestment Act, SASADA as we all know it, has been vital to ratcheting up pressure on Iran. With SASADA as a tool, we have shut down important sources of funding to Iran's nuclear program and related illicit activities. Investment and technical assistance in Iran's upstream oil and gas sector have dropped dramatically. We have sanctioned 10 foreign companies involved in Iran's energy sector and dissuaded energy firms like Shell, Eni, Total, and INPEX from continuing or undertaking sanctionable activities in Iran. Major energy traders from Russia, India, Switzerland, Kuwait, Turkey, France, and the Netherlands have stopped sales of refined petroleum products to Iran. As my OFAC colleague has described, we have used executive orders to designate entities that support or facilitate terrorist or proliferation activity, including Mahan Air, Iran Air, and Tidewater Middle East Company. Last month, we designated 5 individuals for their involvement in Iran's plot to assassinate the Saudi ambassador in the United States. Others, including the European Union and Canada, have already taken or will take similar actions against these individuals. Our policies have been effective in sharpening the choices before the regime. As Iranian President Ahmadinejad recently admitted in a speech to the Majlis, the Iranian parliament, which government can work under so much pressure? This is the heaviest economic onslaught on a nation in history. We are committed to the P5+1 framework to engage with Iran, provided it is prepared to discuss seriously its nuclear program. Until then, we will work with other nations on new sanctions measures. The latest IAEA Director General's report on Iran's nuclear program deepens our concerns, and we are consulting with allies on how to respond at this week's Board of Governors meeting in Vienna. The Iranian regime's unacceptable behavior extends to its human rights abuses. In response to the regime's systematic campaign of violence and intimidation against protesters in 2009, we designated 11 individuals and 3 entities for egregious human rights violations, and we continue to compile evidence to designate the worst abusers. For the past 8 years, we have co-sponsored a UN resolution calling Iran to account for its human rights abuses. Last year, this resolution passed with the largest margin to date. In March, we helped create the position of the Special Rapporteur on Iran, whose recent reporting has shown a spotlight on the regime's repression of its own citizens. We also equip Iranian civil society with capacity-building programs, training, media access, counter-censorship tools, and exchanges to help Iranians defend their fundamental rights and freedoms. Turning to the broader region, we acknowledge the concerns that our military withdrawal from Iraq will allow Iran to expand its influence. However, we also know most Iraqis reject Iran's interference. Iraqi leaders have rebuffed Iranian political pressure, and Prime Minister Maliki has said he will not tolerate the violent activities of Iran-backed militant groups. Iraq is diversifying its foreign relations and developing relationships with EU countries and regional players. In October, Iraqi Foreign Minister Zebari stressed in a press conference with his Iranian counterpart, and I quote, "No other party can fill the vacuum in Iraq except the people of Iraq and the government of Iraq." We are working with Iraqi security forces to strengthen their capabilities beyond 2011, an aspect that Colin can speak to more directly. We are helping Iraq establish credible public institutions that protect its sovereignty and independence. In closing, this administration has expanded the varieties of tools and partners to deter Iran from developing nuclear weapons, continuing its human rights abuses, and destabilizing the regime, the region. Sanctions are having an effect. With the aim of compelling the Iranian regime to change its strategic calculus, we will work with Congress and our allies to increase pressure. It is Iran's responsibility and its self-interest to join the international community of nations. Until then, it only faces growing isolation and condemnation. Thank you once again. I look forward to your questions.